Rosalyne Blumenstein, MSW, producer, director, writer, editor. You've seen her on 2020 and A&E, German primetime television. Rosalyne's words are published in psychological and scientific journals, addiction literature, queer academia, national magazines, and newspapers. As a social worker, Rosalyne has taken pride in her addiction and prevention work. As a national consultant and trainer, Rosalyne has taken pride in her ability to educate her audiences. As a woman of transsexual experience, Rosalyne has taken pride in being a loudmouth tell it like it is, sexually proactive native in Brooklyn, New York. In her book, Brain and Tea, Rosalyne has taken pride in sharing no holds barred, how she has juggled her history of sex work, mental health concerns, addiction, gender identity issues, and academic success. From Canarsie to Times Square, from street corner to City Hall, whether the discussion is sex work or social work, Rosalyne's work, words, visuals, and truth will mesmerize you. Rosalyne Blumenstein, Ross. Hello everyone, and welcome to the special edition of Gay and Loving It. I'm your host, Tony G. Thanks for tuning in. Tonight on our show, we have a very special guest. Her name's Rosalyne Blumenstein, and tonight she's going to share her story and success on her book about Brandon T. Welcome, Rosalyne, to Gay and Loving It. Pleasure having you on the show.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
No problem, and thank you for coming on and letting the world hear about your book and yourself. Mm-mm. So we're going to get started with our first question for tonight. So tell us, Brandon T, what's the title about?
Well, Tony, if you buy the book, you'll find out. No, I'm just kidding. Brandon T, when I first started to write this book, I had a whole other title than this title, Brandon T. Mm-hmm. And it was like a dissertation of sorts. Mm-hmm. And when I moved to California 18 months ago and I was looking steadfastly for a job, I started to write this. And I do a lot of work in regards to oppression, stigma, yada, yada, yada. And Brandon T is just that we live within a system that stereotypes people because of the color and shape of their skin. And Brandon T is touching on T as in red, the scarlet letter, because of my history, I've been branded with a medical term that doesn't really talk to who I actually am and who a lot of people within that T continuum actually are. So,
great. Is this a memoir? And if this is, why is one different from all the books? And what trans personal journeys into womanhood or manhood?
Great questions.
Thank you.
I appreciate that you asked that. In the past, I would say in the United States, in the past like 50 years, there have been memoirs about specifically transsexual people, and amazing
memoirs. Do you have any examples or people you'd like to share with us?
Could you let me finish? No, I'm sorry. God damn it. yes, I do like the Christian Jorgensen story, or I can't think off the top of my head because all those books aren't as important as Brandon.
Of course.
Just kidding. but this actually is not just a memoir. Mm-hmm. I'm a therapist by training. Mm-hmm. So I've used myself in this book as sort of a case analysis. So what this book does is it tells a story, and then I explain different issues in regards to oppression and stigma and sex and sexuality and greed and jealousy and hate and addiction, all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. And then it goes into a healing process. So I tell the story from my heart, and I put on my therapeutic hat and my queer activist hat, and I explain the different situations. I talk about pedophilia. I talk about street life in New York City in the 70s and 80s. Brandon T. touches on Studio 54 era. So it really compiles so much more than just a memoir. Wow. It also includes my challenge on the East Coast around LGBT inclusion and representation.
Great. So who can learn from this book? Anybody, or is it specific in our LGBT? Who can learn from the book?
Well, actually, anybody who buys the damn book will learn from the book. The book is definitely mainstream.
Yes.
It will touch sexual minorities. It will touch racial minorities. My aunt, who is a Navy wife, when she read the book, she said, Brenda T. is pretty graphic, but it's compelling, and it tells a story, and it's academic, and it's scientific, and it's entertaining.
Yeah.
I have a warped sense of humor. So in the darkest parts of my life, in my writing, I bring a lot of humor to the misery. So Brandon T. really is for anybody who can afford to buy, and it's really not that expensive.
So. Wow, great. Some of Brandon T. are extremely graphic and pornographic. Why is that?
I forgot who said this, but as long as I could still carry the tune, I'm going to sing that song. But no, I'm just kidding. Part of my history, I spent quite a number of years lost in the sex industry from the age of 16 on, and this is not a judgment of the sex industry. I talk about the pros and cons of being involved in the sex industry and the price one has to pay for the rest of their life as far as intimacy is concerned.
Yeah.
So Brandon T. really looks at what happens to specifically women of trans experience that transition early in life that are usually thrown out of high school or their home, and how one survives the streets. And the streets of New York City in the 70s were much more colorful than they
are now.
Can you
explain what was so colorful about the streets?
The streets were, Brandon T. talks about places that I lived on, 43rd Street and 7th Avenue, and these transient hotels catered to pimps, prostitutes, junkies, very colorful people,
oh, wow.
Very exciting people, mm-hmm. people that did not have any shade mm-hmm. on who they were. You knew exactly
what who they were, what they did.
Correct. So that's the pornographic component of branded tea. And in branded tea, I have this whole section called Confessions, which now that I'm a social worker mm-hmm. with an advanced degree, I'm not going to hide my history in order to celebrate mm-hmm. my present and future. I choose to talk about my history because my history has made me the woman I am today. So I've worked through a lot of shame mm-hmm. and I've done a lot of healing and mm-hmm. writing branded tea added to that healing mm-hmm. process.
So this is all that brought you to the person who you are today. So you learned from the past, teaching the future.
Mm-hmm.
And this is your baby that you're sharing the world with.
And no stretch marks.
There you go. So what brought you to California and when did you write about Brandon T?
My Nissan Altima brought me to California.
But Greyhound brought me here.
I know you can't see it on the camera. I know you can't see it on the camera, but I was going through a midlife crisis.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked with the fire department right after the 9/11 disaster.
Wow.
And I just needed to make some changes in my life. And when I got to California, as I was looking for work and trying to figure out what California was all about, mm-hmm. I began to write branded tea. It was in my head in 1999, but this is my opportunity to write branded tea. So California is a very different culture, and I'm still getting acclimated to mm-hmm. this wonderful place, but it's very different than the East Coast. And I'm hoping that branded tea will entertain, push folks' buttons, and also bring the queer genre mm-hmm. to a new and exciting level.
Wow, so it's really, really amazing. So now you're a social worker with an advanced degree. Don't you think you're putting your professional credibility on the line by writing your book, Brandon, to you?
That's such an interesting question, because part of why I left New York was to come to California and sort of not be mm-hmm. in the public eye.